And here we go. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, fellow modelers. Welcome to my channel, Building Cool Stuff. My name is Branislav. And today we are building Master Grade Exia. It's a kit that I wanted to build for a while now, for some time. So it's finally its turn. As always, the first step to every build is removing all the parts from the runners. If you intend to paint the way I'm painting, you're gonna take off all the parts and just have them prepped for painting. So sand the nub marks, the remainder of the little plasticky things that connects the parts to the runners, and put them on the alligator clips, get them ready for painting. These are the inner frame parts, so you separate all the parts by color, makes it easier for you. And then you're ready to do the primer. I used pretty much all the paint that I've used was Mr. Hobby, so this is Mr. Hobby gray, light gray primer, 1500 grit, thinned with leveling thinner. Do the nice wet coat, and then, well, I've decided to do pre-shading, as always, gives more character, makes a better paint job altogether. Usually I do the black primer and then go through the middles with the light gray. This time I went the other way around because I was simply trying to save on some black. But I got restocked before ending the video, so I guess it's pointless. I was using Mr. Hobby Off-White for the white parts of Exia. Painted on the pre-shaded parts, it gives really nice results. Red, I can't really tell you what kind of red I've used because I tend to use up all the remains, all the leftovers from the previous paint jobs. So I add a little bit of red, maybe a little bit of white. I have some brown just to get a unique red but still close to what they wanted to do. And this is how I messed up with blue. I got a little bit too dark shade of blue, and it's kind of oversaturated, so it really covered the pre-shading job. And you'll see later I ended up going over and painting with much lighter shade of blue, but like more about it later. All right, so I didn't want to bug too much with painting process because painting for Gundams is pretty straightforward. You have 300 parts and they're on these skewers and you just go and paint through them. And you know what? I gotta talk about this. With all the videos of the model of the Gundam painters that I've been watching here on YouTube, like, people usually say, oh, when I start painting, it's my zen place, it's just me and the paint, and I think of nothing else, it helped me with depression, it helped me with this and that. For me, I gotta say, it's totally opposite. When I start painting, because you don't really need all your brain cells for painting Gundams, at least for the primer or just a straight painting the color on. It's just like half a brain is there. The other half is usually going through all my problems, talking to the people that I'm not happy with. I won't say whom or what. But like, all the problems resurface when I'm doing the paint job. So to be honest, I'm really productive and I do a lot of builds and a lot of paint jobs when I'm satisfied, when I'm happy, when things in life are going well. If I have problems at work, that tends to happen. When I start painting, I'll just go through conversations, you know, remember, well, I'm a guy, so I remember after the argument what I was supposed to say during the argument. So yeah, but that's me. Anyways, you've seen earlier I did Mr. Hobby Dark Iron and Iron for the weapons parts. It's a great paint, you just paint it, it kind of comes out dull and matte and not interesting at all, but you just take cotton buds and go through it, just scrape it off, and it gives awesome metallic looking parts. All the loose parts I use, I got Despia super glue, but like gel super glue, it's not so liquid. It's perfect for these kind of things. It takes a little bit longer to set, to cure, and it just gives you enough time to align everything, put everything the way you want it. As I said before, the blue was too dark, and I was absolutely unhappy with it. I did panel lining. This paint job was a little bit of an unplanned trip, so I did panel lining before I redid the blue. So it's like back and forth. Did a lot of coats of just flat, transparent coats at the end. The panel lining, I did panel lining because it's enamel paint, Tamiya's washes. So I just did it straight on the paint without the top coat, and just, you know, be careful how you remove it with the enamel thinner. So when I redid the blue, I masked it off with the tape. So I didn't want everything, like this was a chance to have like color separation, which is not really, the kit was not made for it, but it gave great results. You'll see by the end of the video, if you stay that long here. So just take a little, it's self-explanatory, take little parts of this masking tape and just cut all parts, of the paint job that you don't want covered. Yeah, it's a pretty satisfying, what is this new word I'm into? Yeah, it's a wholesome, process. Everything is wholesome nowadays, have you noticed? So I mixed up a little bit of sky blue with regular blue and just a bit of white. I don't think it's even showed here. Just like whatever feels right, that's how I approach it. It's a Gundam, it's a, you know, everyone says Gundam is freedom, so Gunpla is freedom. Gunpla is freedom. So you can just paint to whatever makes you feel happy. As always, I did water slides, because you can't really do a good paint job and do some weathering and just put the stickers. Gonna go with the water slides and then just top coat it, and it really fuses these water slides into your painted surface. Toothpicks are the best way to go with aligning and adjusting and moving these water slides until you really press them with the cotton buds. It's not too thick, it's not too sharp, it's just perfect to. I'd like to use this opportunity to thank my friends from the band Bullet for a Badman, or their old name, Metak za Zlikovca. It's a Serbian band from Belgrade, and they're awesome, and I'll leave a link in the description where you can just enjoy their music, or you can just find them on Spotify, so Bullet for a Badman. Or you can just travel to Serbia and listen to them live, because they're one of these bands that sound 10 times better live. They sound excellent in studio recording, and even better live. So yeah, welcome to Serbia. As you can see, the two shades of blue, turned out to be pretty happy. I wasn't that happy with the paint job until I redid this. And here's another custom thing. So once you make master grade 00 kits, I guess, because of this GN drive, you get, well, you don't get, but you should buy their LED kits, or you can get custom kits. Look what China made. It's absolutely amazing. Little LED shows for your GN drives. And it has a magnetic switch. You just bring magnet close to it and it starts working. You hold it next to it for a couple of seconds and it will switch to a different mode, like blinking or running around the lights or... Of course, it doesn't fit perfectly, so you take a file and just brush the edges a little bit and it works pretty well. And you'll see, it looks absolutely amazing. Just look at that. Yeah, at this point I decided to test it. Put it in, the magnet in the back did the job. Yep. But the front, somehow it couldn't trigger the switch. The magnet wasn't big enough or something. But I just moved the light inside a little bit and it worked. And then I needed to top coat it because, like I said earlier, after the water slides, you do the top coat. So I had to protect all the areas that are not supposed to be painted. I used tack, office tack. Oh yeah. And my salt. I used a mix of matte and glossy, trying to get this semi-gloss look, and it worked perfectly. I gotta say that every time I've used matte top coat, I got this snowy, shady, dusty look. Yeah, like it's covered in dust. I was never fully satisfied, but by adding just a little bit of gloss to it, it works perfectly. Oh yeah, turn off the compressor and get back to work. Of course, there is a lot of time passed between these takes because you need to let it set properly. And now it's weathering time, and weathering is, for me, it's the best part of the build. So I just took this wash and applied it through the edges, wetted a little bit and went with the solvent. And then you can just arrange it to whatever you want it to be. Thank you, Mr. Night Shift. Thank you, Mr. Plasmo. Those are the channels that I followed since day one, and they're just amazing modelers. You can just learn so much from them. I don't even know whether this is allowed, mentioning other channels, but I guess it doesn't hurt. And I really did learn a lot from them. So do visit them after you're done watching my video and clicking like and even subscribing. So these guys, they never do Gundams. I guess Plasmo did one Gundam kit. They do tanks and aircrafts and real world stuff. I'm sticking to Gundams because once I leave Asia, I'm in China right now, so once I leave Asia, I go back to Serbia. Serbia doesn't really import Gundams, you don't have stores. If you want to get them from Hobbyland Japan or whatever, you know, you'll pay more for shipping than for actual kits. I don't think I'll have, I'm sure I won't have a backlog the way I have now, a backlog of like 25 kids waiting. So I went with brown wash, which against the mainly white model kit looks really nice. Once you take that solvent, just start pulling it left and right and you get all sorts of effects. I wanted to go for the dirty look, not the look of like rust, because this is an ultimate weapon. No one will leave it in the rain for it to rust. Like, they'll take good care of it. But as if it just got back from a fight, probably on the surface of a planet, and it's all like covered in dust with some scratches here and there. I'm pretty satisfied the way it looked. I think the next model that I'm gonna do is I have this mega-sized Gundam, RX-78-2. I think I'll do that, because you can do even more with the weathering, because it's bigger. A really satisfying part of the build for me is weathering, and you know what? You can easily get pulled into it, and but there is no stopping to it. You can just go weather and do the top coat, which will kind of dull out a little bit your weathering, and then just apply another layer of weathering, and just, you know, forever. Yes, and I used these weathering kits. Don't hate me if I'm wrong, I think they're Tamiya's. And they're really great help. You just dip your brush into, I'm using gun cannon here, gun cannon and rust next to it. Rust looks really good in white, gun cannon for the blue. And it really just go through the edges, and it really gives great results. But like I said previously, when you go with a top coat, because you want to protect this coat of basically dust, the pigment will, in time, I guess it falls off, it kind of disappears, so you want to protect it with a top coat. And then after the top coat, you can do another run with this. So yeah, final assembly. Not really final assembly, but it's one of the final assemblies. Yeah, like I said, I did top coating in between. I didn't record it all because it would just be like the same thing you've seen before. I guess this is the final top coat. The semi-gloss, so matte and gloss mixed, 50-50, I guess, roughly 50-50, one-to-one mixture. Just went through it like heavy coat, made sure I protected it well. I think I've tested out GN Drive here one more time. I had to remove all the tag that I put on the tape that I put to protect the edges. And we're almost there. I love building model kits, but I gotta tell you one thing. Ever since I started recording, so this is like the fourth video, I did four or five kits, fully painted kits in between, that I just didn't record. Recording takes away a lot from the overall feeling of building and painting and just like enjoying the build. I've recently texted a guy who I'm following, like this guy does amazing kit bashes. I'm following him on Instagram, and I said, this is what I told him. I said, I know that it's selfish of me to ask, but I would love to see videos, but I know how much it takes away from the build process. And he 100% agreed with me. He's like, yep, that's exactly why I don't do it. What you're looking at now is the dry brushing. So I did with the silver or the chrome. One way or the other, you'll get good result. Just dip your brush in it, dry it against the paper. When it's almost no paint left on the brush, just go through the edges. I've described it in detail in previous videos, so then in the end you can take the little tiny precise brush and just enforce some of the details and you'll get nice, very nice scratch details. Okay, GN Drive operational. Look at that. And Exia is ready to go. There we go. I think I've spent around 20 hours on this kit, maybe a bit less. I had a lot of footage, so I had like 15 hours of footage. And I didn't record everything, so. Ladies and gentlemen, Master Grade Exia. Really nice, posable kit, great proportions, looks wonderful, feels great. You paint it properly, it just looks amazing. All right, well, thank you for staying until the end of the video. If you've stayed, you might as well click like button. I dare you to subscribe to the channel and enjoy more builds to come. Thanks again and see you in the next video.